Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Scott from MuscularStrength.com, and today we're going to continue the Versus series by comparing the lat pushdown to the dumbbell pullover. Now, if you've missed any of the videos in this series, I'll post the link to the entire playlist at the end of the video. And as always, if you have a suggestion for a future Versus series video, you can let me know by commenting below. So this topic came up because I was recently training at a 24-hour fitness while at the LA Fit Expo, and I met a subscriber who was training back, and we both arrived at the cable machine at the exact same time. And we had that awkward moment where we're both like, you gonna use that? Yeah, we can jump in together? Okay, cool. But luckily, we both had the same exercise in mind anyways, and we ended up training together. And during the sets, we started chatting about different back exercises, and he asked me if I ever do the dumbbell pullover. Essentially, he was asking which exercise would produce the most gains or a bigger and thicker back, and that's what brings us here. So to properly answer that question, we first need to talk about the differences between the two exercises. But before we get started, Jed North has just released a new line, and to celebrate, I'm giving away two $100 gift cards. To enter is easy. Click the link in my pinned comment to check out the new line, and then comment below one item you would purchase with your gift card. Then follow Jed North on Instagram and tag a friend on this photo. I'll pick both winners by the end of the week, but if you see something you really want right now, make sure you use my code SCOTT20 for 20% off your entire order at checkout. All right, so first up is the lat pushdown. Now, to perform a lat pushdown, you need access to a cable machine and a straight bar attachment. Then step a few feet away from the machine so that even at the starting position, there's constant tension on your back. Next, while maintaining a slight bend in your elbows, bend your knees, keep your chest up, and arch your back to create as much of a stretch as possible in your lats. Once in place, push the bar towards your hips without changing the angle of your elbows, and as the bar reaches your thighs, continue to stick your chest up and flex your back. Then return to the starting position while controlling the negative and repeat for reps. But some key notes, guys. Make sure you're bracing your abs throughout the entire set, and don't bend your elbows more than just slightly. Also, don't grab the bar too wide because this will reduce the overall range of motion, restricting the effectiveness of the movement. Now, this exercise primarily targets the lats, posterior deltoids, teres major, and triceps. The lats are responsible for extending and immediately rotating the upper arms in towards your body. The posterior deltoid is on the back of the shoulder. It helps pull your arm down and back during the movement. The teres major is a small muscle that spans from the bottom of your shoulder blade to the side of your arm and helps extend the shoulder, and the triceps help bring your arms down, aiding your lats. As for the dumbbell pullover, this exercise can be executed in two different laying positions. The first is by laying flat on a bench, and the second is by laying off to the side of the bench with just your upper back on the pad. However, the dumbbell pullover is very unique in that it can be used to target chest or back, and your starting position is going to help in determining which muscle you're targeting. So if we're trying to isolate more lats, you would want to use the second starting position and also focus on pulling with your elbows, keeping your biceps and grip disengaged as much as you can without dropping the weight. In fact, I've actually made a video in the past discussing how to use this exercise for chest or lats. So if you want to dive a bit deeper into that subject, I'll drop a link to that video in my pinned comment. But why does a starting position change how we target the muscles with this exercise? Well, it's because in the second variation, you're actually able to dip your hips and extend your lower back a lot more, which will allow you to get a better stretch and contraction on the lats. So really try to let your hips sink below the surface of the bench when doing this exercise. So then which one should you incorporate into your next back workout? Well, it's a pretty cut and dry case, right? Well, there's a twist. It's neither, guys. In fact, I would suggest that we combine elements of both exercises, such as the hand positioning of the dumbbell pullover with the overall form of the lat pushdown, and you get the straight arm lat pulldown. Now, you'll activate your abs a bit more for stability with this exercise, specifically speaking your trunk flexors or the rectus abdominis and external obliques, and your triceps will engage a bit more as well because you'll need to contract them to keep your elbows straight. But in terms of overall stretch, lat activation, and mind-muscle connection benefits, this exercise is going to be the real winner for the Versus series video, and for a few really good reasons. Number one, it offers greater range of motion than lat pushdowns. Number two, if you have limited overhead shoulder mobility, you won't be able to perform the dumbbell pullover. And number three, because of the movement pattern, you will feel more overall lat activation, especially in the lower and middle part of the muscle. But one last thing before you run off to the gym to try this exercise. None of these exercises, guys, are what I would consider to be a mass builder, okay? They're more like assisted mass builders. And what I mean by that is exercises like pull-ups, bent over rows, or T-bar rows should be staples in your programming, as they will allow you to lift the most weight and produce the best gains. However, exercises like the lat pushdown, straight arm pulldown, or dumbbell pullover should be utilized as either the first exercise on your back training day to pre-fatigue your back for better mind-muscle connection throughout your workout, or as a finisher to push more overall volume into your workout, or maybe your full body training, it might be a good idea to toss these exercises in as a superset on your high volume days. But no matter how you plan to incorporate the exercises, I would still stick with the straight arm pull down using a rope to maximizing the efficiency of trying to target the lats. Be sure to tap that like button if you enjoyed the video, subscribe so you never miss a new video upload from me, and if you're looking for a new program to help you build more muscle, lose fat, or bust through a current training plateau, you can take my 2-minute quiz to help you find the right program for your goals. All my programs come complete with follow-along training videos, form demonstrations, and downloadable PDFs so you can take your workouts with you anywhere. I'll drop you guys a link in my pinned comment below to the quiz, and as always, more good stuff coming soon. Hey guys, as promised, over here is the link to the entire playlist of my Versus series videos, and if my program selector tool piqued your interest, just click the link down here to be brought directly to it. No BS or fluff training, guys, just programming around exercises and training principles that drive results. See you next time.